So I want everyone to be cool with people's mistakes now. We're all gonna be, in fact, I'm gonna tell you a story right now about one of the worst mistakes I have made in the last 5 years, and we're gonna laugh about it. And that's how we're gonna be when someone says they voted, and next time they go, dude, what happened? I can't believe I did this. You're not gonna get mad. You're not gonna get me, hey, yeah, yeah, fuck you, he's not my president. Yeah, you live here too, fucker. Yeah, he is. By the way, you don't have to like it, but we gotta figure out how to fix it. And the only way that's gonna happen is we. Okay, so, I'm gonna tell you a story. And you guys, it's the worst thing I did in the last 5 years. I started drinking when I was 15 years old. I stopped drinking at 17 because I fell into a bonfire. Oh, I got really good at drinking. That's gold medal level right there. Alcoholics Anonymous sent me a certificate that just said, wow. And then under that it said, we can't help you. So I stopped drinking at 17 years old. I didn't drink again until I hit 41. I met my new girl, watched dinner one night. Having dinner, and I had water. And she goes, how come you're not having a drink? And I go, because I fell into a bonfire when I was 17. And she goes, but you're not 17 anymore. You're a grown-ass man. And I thought, wow, you're an alcoholic. She said, no, I'm just saying, you're not making the decision of a child. You're a grown man. Have a drink. I go, do you run an alcohol distribution company? What is wrong with you? And then she said, I'm just saying a real man would have a drink. She's from Louisiana. I said, okay. And she was showing a lot of side boobs. So I said, yeah. I am only flesh and blood. And she was right. I was an older man, different guy, a different life. I had a drink, I'm fine. I can drink, it's good. Everything's fine, everything's fine. I can drink. But recently something happened. And by the way, and I'm the worst kind of drunk because I'm a happy drunk. You can't piss me off. And we'll be in a bar somewhere. Someone's going, what the hell are you looking at? Your hair is amazing. Is that a mousse or a pomade? Because you are beautiful, Brad Pitt. Oh, you want to do me homo? No, but we can get married legally now. Hell, I'll even bake you a cake. I'm going to need a couple more of these, though. Because I know my mouth is gorgeous. I'm the guy when people are dragging me out and I'm nothing out. I'm like, what? We're just talking. No, he's gonna kill you. Why? What? Is he mad? Like, oh, give me a hug. Come on, it's okay. Hug it out. Hug it out. I'm a pain in the ass, dude. I'm the worst. So, you know, I can drink. Everything's fine. So I got, but I got one. Okay, so a while back I got home from one of my road gigs and on Monday I take the day off and I watch my shows on my DVR. I was watching Street Outlaws. Whatever it is. And I had three glasses of wine. I poured a whole bottle into three glasses of wine. And I drank it over 3 hours, he says, to justify his behavior. I got done drinking, it was 3 hours. I remembered, I went upstairs and my wife was already in bed. And I get in bed and she goes, hey, your throat sounds kind of raspy. I want you to take this Benadryl. Oh. I didn't know this part. See, this is the part. I don't take medication. I did not know that wine plus wine plus wine plus Benadryl equals, oh my God, no. And that's the second math joke I have ever written. So I took the Benadryl because I love her and I just, wish you could just hand me anything. Take this, okay. Why am I foaming now? She's just counting money. No reason. Keep going. People, I took that Benadryl of that wine. I slept like I have never slept in my life. Almost went into the light. Woke up the next morning like I had a blood transfusion. I'm like, I feel incredible. This must be what Oprah and Keith Richards do. This is incredible. Woo! But my house was weird. Like, my wife woke up, she was grumpy, but she wakes up grumpy sometimes, I didn't think about that. But my dogs were inconsistent, and my dogs are very consistent. Every morning, I wake up, my older dog just face rapes me for 5 minutes, that's what he does. This morning, though, he was sitting at the end of the bed as far as he could get away from me, going... Our younger dog, who's the dark soul, he listens to Nine Inch Nails all the time. Usually under the bed shivering. This morning, however, he's bouncing all over me like whatever I did last night, we were buddies gonna hang out in the smoking area and carve our initials in our arm. I didn't think anything of it. I just went about my day. And my wife didn't say anything to me, but instead, as I'm going about my day, she started to noise me into an argument. Oh, yeah, about that guy? Yeah, yeah. She wouldn't say anything. But I got my coffee, I'm walking down the hall, and as she goes by me, she goes, "You shouldn't know what I'm doing right now." Because I walked past her 2 hours later, and she just went, "Wow." And I'm not biting. I know it's coming. I'm not going to bite. I just keep ignoring her. And about 2 hours later, she walks past me, and she just goes, "Unbelievable." "What?" And she whips on me, and she goes, "Do you know what you did last night?" And that sentence is never followed by, "You saved a baby from a fire." "You cured cancer, filed a patent, and we never have to work again. That's what you did last night." So I sat down on the edge of the bed, because I'd heard that sentence before when I was 17. And I said, "No, what did I do last night?" And she said, "You were sleeping like I've never seen you sleep." And I said, "I remember that." She said, "About 3 a.m., you got up to go to the bathroom. You shouldn't be that far ahead of me on this." "You got up to go to the bathroom, walked into the closet, opened your pants, then opened your pajama drawer, and filled it." And I said, "With what?" Because I didn't want the dogs to have one up on me. She said, "Then you pulled up your pants, closed your pajama drawer, and flushed it by flicking off the light switch." I peed in my pajama drawer. Now, I know a lot of you are more weirded out that I have a pajama drawer. But my wife loves Jimmy Stewart, and she likes me to sleep silky. Our safe word is Harvey. I made a dumb mistake. It's a dumb mistake. It was a dumb mistake. So next time you liberals, once that next Trump people go, "God, I voted for this guy, and man, he's just not living up to it. I wish I hadn't voted for him." Don't get in their face. It's okay. You peed in your pajama drawer. It's all right.